and welcome to HP How To For You. I'm Steph, and this is Bill, and we are here to bring you tips, tricks, and how-to information every 2 weeks to help you get more out of your HP products.
In our last episode, we were at the HP Experts Global Meetup in San Francisco, and we brought you tips from our experts on the HP support forums. We heard a lot about Windows 10 at the meetup.
It was all anyone could talk about. So we may have gone to the Giants game and watched some really great expert panels.
Windows update.
We took a lot of pictures. I even taught people how to belly dance. But the coolest thing was that while we were there, I upgraded my PC to Windows 10. I think I might need to update some of my drivers, though.
You probably do. Whether you're having problems with touchpad, touchscreen, Wi-Fi, video, any of those issues, you name it, the single most common solution is to update your drivers in Windows 10. And if you're not having any issues, it's still a good idea to run Windows Update so that any issues that may occur for older drivers are eliminated when you update those new drivers. And if you did everything you said you did at the meetup, you were busy.
I was busy having fun. So, tell me, how do I update my drivers and software after upgrading to Windows 10?
Let's first talk about driver updates. Now, there's a few different ways to do this, and we're going to show you a couple of different options. The first is Windows Update. And running Windows Update is really easy. So, first of all, you want to make sure that you're connected to the internet. To launch Windows Update, you click on the Start menu, then you click on Settings. Settings will open up and you'll see Update and Security. Windows Update is listed there. Clicking on that will launch Windows Update. Once Windows Update opens, you want to click on Install Updates. Once the updates are installed, you may need to restart your computer.
Is that it? Just install the updates through Windows Update?
Not quite. I actually recommend that you run Windows Update again until it displays your device is up to date. You can click on Check for Updates again to make sure that there's nothing else out there. And once you do that, then you're done.
So you mentioned that there are other ways to install the updates.
Yep. So you can install driver updates through HP Support Assistant as well. I suggest that you run both Windows Update and HP Support Assistant, because HP Support Assistant may have drivers prior to Windows Update, because those drivers that are in HP Support Assistant are coming directly from HP and may not have made it to Windows Update yet. So you can launch HP Support Assistant from the Start menu, similar to how we launched Windows Update. So you click on the Start menu and then All Apps, scroll down to HP Help and Support, and then you can select HP Support Assistant. You can also launch HP Support Assistant from the taskbar if it's been launched before. You'll see the little blue icon with the question mark in it. Clicking on that will actually launch HP Support Assistant. When it launches, you'll be on the support page after the welcome screen, and you'll see your devices listed there. At the bottom of the My Device screen, you'll see Updates. That's how you check for updates. It's really simple. Once you launch that, the updates will be listed, or if there's no updates, it'll say no updates available for you at this time. And if you're still having issues, you can use Device Manager, the third way that we can check for updates. To launch Device Manager, you can right-click on the Start menu, select Device Manager. Now, Device Manager is best in troubleshooting something very specific, where you can uninstall and reinstall a driver specific to an issue, like if you're having a video issue or a sound issue or a Wi-Fi issue. To do that, once Device Manager is opened, we're going to use Display Adapter as an example. We'll click on Display Adapter, we'll right-click on the device that's listed there. In this case, it shows an Intel graphics driver. And at the very top is Update Driver Software. So you can click on Update. Again, make sure that you're connected to the internet. You can search automatically for updated driver software. Once that happens, it'll go out to the internet and check for the update and install the latest one. whether it's from Microsoft updates or from Intel or from HP, it will look for that specific update.
So that covers all the driver updates. What about software and app updates?
Well, for any kind of software that came with your PC, you can use HP Support Assistant. It'll go out and look for those updates just like it will for drivers.
Oh, cool.
Now, for other applications, like for Windows applications that you may have installed when you first got your PC from the Microsoft Store, you can use the Microsoft Store to go out and check for updates for those apps. You can also browse around and look for apps there. Now, the important thing on that is that you have to have a Microsoft account to access the Microsoft Store, but you can get any apps updated that way as well. That's it. We really recommend that you make all of these updates before you do anything else after upgrading to Windows 10. It'll help your PC run a lot smoother.
Thanks, Bill. My hero. Don't let it get to your head. Once you've updated all of your drivers, you should be ready to get started with any of those new apps. You can set up apps like your mail, calendar, weather, news, and get started using Cortana. So let us know if there is anything else you want to know about Windows 10.
Thanks for joining us today. Catch our next episode in 2 weeks on September 23rd, where we talk about some new tools that HP has developed for troubleshooting your PC.
Oh yes, you don't want to miss that one. So stay tuned and catch us on HP How To For You. You can find us on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/howtoforyou or on our HP support forum at
hp.com/support forum.
Check us out there in the blog section. Let us know what you want to hear about in our next episodes.
Awesome. See you next time, guys.
Bye. Ow.
Ow, that hurt. That's it. We really recommend that
you start. Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
Boop.